Hebrews 13.
Arabaleng ba Hebrew 13.
5, verse 5.
Arabaleng ba Hebrew 13, arabaleng molao verse 5.
I'll read there. Can you read in Amplified, Mama? Verse 5 and 6.
5 and 6. Let your character, your moral essence, your inner nature be free from the love of money. Shun greed, be financially ethical, being content with what you have. For he has said, I will never, under any circumstances, desert you, nor give you up, nor leave you without support, nor will I in any degree leave you helpless, nor will I forsake or let you down, or relax my hold on you, assuredly not. So we take comfort and are encouraged and confidently say, the Lord is my helper. In time of need, I will not be afraid. What will men do to me?
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I want us to talk about a very sensitive topic today. It really affects our Christian life. Be careful of greedy. Write it down. Be careful of greedy. I was supposed to be saying greedy. Let me say, greedy is as good as doubt. Greedy is our enemy. Behind greedy, there's a spirit of Satan. The moment you are filled with the spirit of Satan, you become greedy. Greedy makes you to fight for a position that you are not. Greedy makes you to fight for the position that you will never inherit. It really eliminates you from his God's presence. You will never quote God if you are greedy. And the moment you quote God when you are greedy, you are a hypocrite. If you can see where we are reading, the Bible says, be free from the love of money.
Be free
from greedy.
Tell
everybody, be free from the love of money. Or be free from greedy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you see the verse there? Be free from the love of money and shun greed. And then be content with what you have. And as he has promised that he will never leave us. And the Lord is going to be able to stand with you. You'll be able to say, the Lord is my helper. If you can see this verse, it says, let your conduct is without covetousness. Be content with such things as you have. For he himself said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. This verse shows that it's only God that will provide what we need. Greedy makes us to develop ways of enrich ourselves.
Me ha ba ri dira re teleditse la tsa go gona o te gomisha.
And we forget that it's only the Lord that can take care of ourselves.
Ra leba lore ke morena fela ya ka re gontshang o te tokomela.
You know, the moment when greed enters you,
kana ko ye me ha ba re o itsena,
you invite wrong people to attack you.
O mema le ba ba seng bona gore ba tle ba wa attacke.
That's why here the Bible says, you will say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear what can men do to me.
O tla gona o bolela wa re morena ke mothusi wa ka, a ke tshabe silo a go se motho a ka ntiang sona.
Because it's only when the Lord provides that a man cannot steal from you.
Ke ge modimo o fa tse o di thokang ke mo motho ka se gone o ta utswetsa.
But whatever you get by greedy,
mara ka o fela tse o di gwetjang ka mehabaru,
you open a doors for men to come and destroy you.
O bola mabatu bolela batho re bate ba gona go fedisha. Amen.
So greed is very dangerous.
Ya mehabaru e kotse.
Because everyone who's greedy,
ka re motho ka moka ya nang le mehabaru,
is in competition.
O ipapetsa le bomongwe.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Look at this verse, 1 Timothy 6.
Are ba leng verse ye mola o Timothy wa mathomo chapter 6
from verse 9 and 10.
Are ba le verse 9 le verse 10 ya na mola.
It says, but those who are crave to get rich, they fall in various and harmful and foolish reign and destruction. Just read that verse, mama.
But those who are not financially ethical and crave to get rich with a compulsive, greedy longing for wealth fall into temptation and a trap and into many foolish and harmful desires that plunge people into ruin and destruction, leading to personal misery.
Okay, let's talk about that here. It says they fall into foolish and harmful.
Batsenaka re a dilo tsa botaela le tsa go batsa.
And all this leads someone to misery.
And a checka o fela di sa motho mongwe dilo.
You know, I heard the Bible says, I mean, when you are blessed by God, there's no sorrow with it.
A o shufa di tsheke botima o na le dilo mo go tsona.
But this one is like developing your own strategies.
Mara e o ka re kuta le ditsiranyana nya tsa hao.
Get rich.
Tsa o le ka gore o te gomishe.
The craveness of becoming rich.
Janong taba yela ya o lela o te goma.
Makes you to develop some ways which are harmful.
E dira rote le ditsela tse di mo
tshe
di ta o isang gore wena o fedishwe.
Unless if you allow God to guide you.
Kante ha e o dumela morena ba yena wa o hlata.
You develop things that, you know, always you cry and you won't reach there.
Somebody can give you 10 million today.
You cry for 20 million. Not long I found that there's no money that can satisfy you. These things of the world can't satisfy you. The craviness in you to become rich. There are things that will rise up in you and make you to find ways. And those ways are harmful.
And
they rain your life and think by the last minute when you find that you have done everything, but you are nothing. You can ask people who are very rich, many of them, they are in misery.
Many
things you are crying for, you don't need them. For example, you need a triple story. When you reach on top there, you're like this. I've experienced that. I began to say, what will happen when I'm 8
years?
I don't need this. there are things we are crying for when we are young, but
the moment we have them, we find
they are useless. I don't know if you're hearing that.
Eh?
Amen. Are you hearing that?
Like,
tell your neighbor, stop crying for things that will bring misery.
Alright, look at that verse. Read verse 10, Mama.
We read verse 9. You say what?
For the love of money, that is the greedy desire for it and the willingness to gain it unethically, is a root of all sorts of evil, and some by longing for it have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows.
They've pierced their souls. Just read it again, the last stand of that verse. You say what?
It says, where does it start? It says, it have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves through and through with many sorrows.
In other words, that's what greed does.
It
shifts you from faith
and
makes you to be in misery, because you'll be thinking,
how
can I make money?
How
can I be rich? And this greediness also take you to competition. Okay, I saw that one having this, I want to have it. That is greedy for you. You don't live your life, you compete your life with others. When you are greedy, you want to be on top than others. It's a root of all evils. You can do everything to be on top. Greedy people, they can even kill you to be on top.
They
don't want anybody in front of them.
Whoever
competes them is in danger. Hallelujah.
Amen.
2 Timothy 3 verse 2, it says,
Timothy 3
especially verse
2,
if we read it, it says,
Timothy 3 verse 2, for people will be lovers of self, narcissist, self-focused, lovers of money, impelled by greed, boastful, arrogant, revilers, disobedient to parents, ungrateful, unholy, and profane.
All these six things you are reading are some fruits of the people who have got greedy. Who are greedy. People will crave to be rich, but here it says they will be lovers of themselves. In other words, they will be self-focused.
Self-sufficient.
They'll be proving a point. But they will do that because they are impelled by greedy. Their focus of loving money will be impelled by greedy.
Proud
boosters.
You
cannot boost when you don't have anything. You cannot be arrogant when you don't have anything. Can you just read these other things? Arrogant, pride, all those kind of things.
It says, for people will be lovers of self.
Lovers of selves.
Self-focused.
Self-focused.
Lovers of money.
Lovers of money.
Impelled by greed.
All right, look here. All this is people who are impelled by greed. Once you are pushed by greedy, self-focus,
love
of yourself. Can you just read other things there?
Lovers of money, yes. Impelled by greed, boastful,
boastful,
arrogant,
arrogant,
revilers,
revilers,
disobedient to parents.
Parents are nothing.
Ungrateful.
These people, even if you do the best, they will never say thank you. Because already they are pelled by greedy.
When
greedy pushes you, you reach a level where nobody cannot say anything to you. Greed is very dangerous because it establishes wrong characters in you. Nobody can tell you anything. Have you ever find you reach a level where no one can tell you? Because you know how much is in your account.
Boastful.
Now you can talk about your cars, your houses. How far you are educated. How far you are educated. Is when greed is in you. Once it enters you, you show other people that they are small. Okay, let's read, Mama.
It says,
the last part
disobedient to parents, ungrateful,
ungrateful,
unholy and profane.
Unholy and profane. Any sin is possible.
Also,
they are profane.
The word profane means
they are diluted.
There
are some things you are doing that does not make you clean. The Bible talks about sanctification. It means there are certain things you are not part of. You don't want to be part of everything that can affect your faith. So here you find that they are profane.
Diluted.
They can answer whatever they can answer. They can
sleep the way
they... No one can tell them anything. And this will happen in the last days. This thing is in our time.
Characters
like this matters around the people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to tell you, ask your neighbor and say, what is it that you are boasting about? Say, answer me. Can we read Luke 12? From verse 15, Jesus was teaching about this.
Luke 12 from verse 15.
Just read from verse 15. It says, Luke 12.
Luke 12.
Yes.
Verse 15. Then he said to them, watch out and guard yourself against every form of greed. For not even when one has an overflowing abundance does his life consist of is it derived from his possessions.
I just want you to look at that verse. I want to explain it. Jesus here, he explained to the disciples and people were there. He said, watch out. All forms of greed. In other words, there are different ways of greedy. Or that can lead you to greediness. So Jesus said, watch out. Just watch out. In other words, be careful. Okay, just read, continue.
He
says what?
Watch out and guard yourselves against every form of greed.
Every form, yes. Read 16.
Verse 16.
Yes.
Then he told them a parable saying,
yes,
there was a rich man whose land was very fertile and productive. And he began thinking to himself, what shall I do, since I have no place large enough in which to store my crops? Then he said, this is what I will do. I will tear down my storehouses and build larger ones, and I will store all my grain and my goods there. And I will say to my soul, soul, you have many good things stored up, enough for many years. Rest and relax, eat, drink, and be merry. celebrate continually. But God said to him, you fool, this very night your soul is required of you. And now who will own all the things you have prepared?
Where we are reading now, it shows that there are forms of greedy. And once you enter one form of
greedy,
you can be find yourself missing your redemption.
You can find
that you are not aware of the times.
In fact,
people are so busy because of greedy to the extent that they don't know their day of death.
You know, when I
grew up, I'm sure there's something that I saw when these old people were dying. Nowadays, it's no longer happening. I saw this thing in my grandmom.
Passed on
1975. I saw that.
In
76, my grandfather passed on.
76,
but these old people, they had time to say, my time is finished.
Call all my children.
And explain to them everything.
And
from there they die. You see, they had times of what they believe on,
which had
given them sign of their redemption. Look what is happening to us today. You are still planning, you see, tomorrow I will do this, tomorrow the car hit you,
you
die. I don't know if you're hearing me. You are in your forms of redemption.
Let me say
of greedy. And you don't know the times of redemption. This man was so rich. He was looking at the progress of his things. And he said, it's better I destroy this, I expand.
It's like I'm seeing walking around these bands.
At the moment when he was finishing saying that, he spoke proudly like others.
He said,
now you see yourself now. As if he's looking at himself in the mirror.
He said,
you see, it's time for you to eat now. It's time for you to eat. Not knowing that the Lord will demand the same
thing.
Listen, forms of greedy keeps you
busy.
You forget the times of God. Many of us, we don't even know the season we are in before God. So much busy. Trying to make money that we cannot get. And sometimes when we reach somewhere, we become boastful. We plan the more. The Bible says we must never lean on our own understanding. But most of the time we find we are standing. Can you just read that verse where the Bible says he told himself? He said what? Read from 20.
It says, but God says to him, yes, you fool, this very night your soul is required of you. And now who will own all the things you have prepared?
My God, you people, if you reach there, you realize that what you have now is not yours. Not long I was looking at my age. I was looking at the age of my wife. And my wife was telling me something. She said, please don't do what other people are doing. There's something that I told my wife. I said, you will divorce me before. The moment you hear that, you will just divorce me. So we're laughing then.
So now
I'm going
to retire.
And she said, why are you saying that? I said, look at my time.
Your time.
If you know you don't have time,
ha o tsika tsebora o sana nako,
you will always be ready.
What adula we to kishiche.
Do you know that we are living in a time where we feel like we have got too much time?
Le tseba re phila mona ko nyere tong karana le nako engata.
And we feel like we can get things to take us there.
And re tong karana ka khwetsa dilo di ri chie di ri semola.
And the greed is working in us.
Khanti me ha ba ruki yona e boerekang mo gorena.
Greed is really working.
Me ha ba ruka nnete ya bereka mo gorena.
You want to be rich.
Unyoko
you
huma,
want to be famous.
Unyoko
tsebe ya, you want to be known.
Unyoko tsebiwa.
After that,
kamra wa mo aba utsiba.
After you are known,
kamra wa utsiwa.
After you had all this money,
kamra
wa
usweri chelati ya lefasile kamka ka ufela.
What will happen?
Utodia la.
Does it change you?
Uya tabachedi ya ufetusa.
Does it add your length?
Tabachedi ya uoketa wa mutelele nyana oba wanona nyana. Oba we are good matuko.
There are things we are crying for which are very, very useless.
Wana le dilo cherry lelang chedi tokang ngola.
And then for us to seek God and his direction.
O fetisho re nyake modimo le tshupatsela ya ha.
I'm not saying to have money is wrong.
Ankere oba le chelete ke phoso nne.
I say greed is an attack.
Ke roba le meha ba roki attack.
All of us here we are attacked with greed.
Ka o fela ina re attackilwe ka ba le meha ba ro ha modimo asiyo tabeng
kere. But if God is involved, he will guide us.
Mara modimo a le gona o tla hlatha re tsapile.
Each step of the
way. Are isa ba tong bo bongwe le bo bongwe tseleng.
I don't know if you're hearing me.
A ke tseba le ntwa.
Bible says seek the kingdom all shall follow.
Ba le nya ka mmuso ka o fela le to shala marao.
Go provide.
Modimo ta o fa tse o di tsoka.
If you believe, say amen.
A o tumela re amen.
Proverbs 11 verse 6.
Diema 11:6.
Proverbs 11 verse, he says the righteousness of the upright will rescue them, but the treacherous will be caught by their own greedy.
Ba ba ditsela na tshe dimpi ba ta swarwa ke me ha ba re yo bona.
The righteous
baloki
with their own faithfulness
ka u botea ga bona
will be rescued.
Batla bolokwa
take it to another level.
Batla tshiwa ba isotulong engwe.
But greediness will catch you.
Mara ba me ya ba rena ba tlo tshwarwa.
In fact, you can get money in the wrong way, money in the wrong way, one day they will catch you.
Wow, ukathola tshelete ka tsela isiyo ma tshelene
ngo tshwana. That's what the scripture say. It says one day they will really catch you. You can steal in that factory.
Cha tshelele ngwe ba to tshwara ka o tswana ke wo mo leng teng.
But one day they will catch you.
Cha tshelele ngwe lona ba tono ta ba o tshwara.
And you find that you have wasted your time.
Matlo ro ralukile ka nako.
I don't know if you hear me.
A ke tseba lentwa.
You know, I was looking at don't be surprised if I mention that.
Na ke lebelela le ska makala ke bolela ka tabai.
There are some profession, let me call them profession, which are very much dangerous.
Ona le mishumo ye mengwe le nkotse kotse.
Especially on the money issue.
Kudu kudu ari tatabengela ya chelete.
The first one is to be a doctor.
Ya mathomo ikuba mwalafi dokotela.
To be a doctor is very dangerous.
Uba dokotela zwi khombonga manda.
You can operate people who are not supposed to be operated.
O ka operator le ba ba sa swanela ngo operatio.
You just go there, you find that this person does need this.
O no thola uri muthu a tokisilo.
You want big money, you operate.
Kala kala ro nya ka chelete wa re ke tshuntsho re ku di e moaro nga tshivenda.
You can make your people your customers.
O ka di abathu bo ba bitle di customer cha ha.
Doctors are very dangerous.
Bo doctor ba kotsi kudukudu.
But it's a good profession that God has established to help his people.
Mara ke mmereko mo botso modimo o dumeletseng gore batho ba ga e ba thushe.
All this profession I want to tell you.
Mishimo ye ka mpaka moka. Ke ya unyo gore batho ba thusha gale.
The second one is pastory.
Ya bobedi ke borudi.
Pastors, we are danger also.
Baroti mukotse.
Pastors, when they are given money, they don't ask where it's coming from.
Aba fi wachelata, abu chishilo wuchuru chelate itakai.
And pastors, we love to say sow a seed.
And arerata kudukuru reta ujwale peo.
Our people sow a seed until they are tired.
Batu bajwala peo baba bakhatala.
After they sow a seed.
Kamera wajwala peo.
When you tell like this, the money of a seed is going to buy chicken.
Au jika fela ispeu yela ya hawe yore ka go.
I don't know if you hear me.
A ke tsaba lento.
The third one is lawyers.
Ya borarui ki boramlao.
Lawyers, they are very, very good in greediness.
Bo boramlao ba kotse kudukudu mo mehabarong.
Sometimes there are things they found that people they don't know.
And
they can get those things on the other side without making you to know. Yes, are intelligent. They look at you like, you know, these people who sell cars. They look at you and say, these shoes. They look at you, they say,
no.
Consultation fee, 30,000. If you just come with my reposa, they say, where are you working? They can't stand for you. Even
Jesus
gave example by them. He said there was an evil lawyer.
You know,
it means this lawyer was a greedy one. So the widow normally goes there and says, please, the whole night, help me. I don't know if you're hearing that. There's some profession that you know God has established there. And Satan wants to manipulate them by greediness.
And
those are the professions which are very important. We need to pray for them. And we need to pray for such people. Once all of them are effective, automatically it means God can be established. Greediness is very dangerous. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Pastor, are you not greedy? Look at the person's face, you see greedy. You will just see greedy.
Pastor,
are you not greedy? So greedy makes you to act in a way that people have to question you. In fact, I'm slowing down to look at you. I see you deliver from greedy. I'm just seeing you being delivered. And once you are delivered, you will see God first. And all shall follow you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Let me just speak about pastors. Many crusades that we
crusade
do
are
pushed by greedy.
Not by Holy Spirit.
Even conferences.
Conference.
How much can we make? How much can we make? This morning when I was hearing this message, I began to pray, God, do you want me to cancel this service? I was asking God to cancel this service.
I'm
coming to this service because of greedy. I was asking God, I prayed. I left my room and go and pray in another
room.
Because I found that even some things we are doing, it's not Holy Spirit based, it's greedy. God sent me to go for crusade where? I went to crusade in Taiwan. I was with my son-in-law. I began to say, God, I'm no longer feeling, there's too much money here. People are giving us money. In that night, I failed to sleep. I began to pray. I was visited by a man who was holding a sword. And he said to me, you are still going to travel. Your God will send you to many nations. That day when I was going to the service, I was confident. I was excited. Because I was praying after I saw, this is too much money. I don't know if you're hearing me. When money comes to you, to pray, don't say thank you. Ask direction about it. Because it can be there to confuse your direction. It can be there to mislead you. Or to block millions that are coming. I don't know if you're hearing me. Not all blessings are blessings. Can you tell your neighbor? Not all blessings are blessings. Others can ignite greedy. You can be surprised now now you have started this, you move, you get another greedy. You start to. And once you carry on with greediness, it's possible you can be attacked physically. Think about crusade here, crusade there.
Crusade,
for big people, many people to come. God can still guide you in individual person. Let's leave there. Let's read another verse.
Maybe.
2 Peter 2:12. The Bible says from 12 to 16. There are people who are born to be captured. There are people that are born to be destroyed because of that greedy. In other words, number one, greedy makes you to destroy some people and you'll be destroyed by the greedy. You capture to be captured. Just read that verse. You destroy to be destroyed.
Okay. But these false teachers, like unreasoning animals, mere creatures of instinct, born to be captured and destroyed, reviling things they do not understand, will also perish in their own corruption. In their destroying, they will be destroyed, suffering wrong destined for punishment. As for wages of doing wrong, they count it a delight to reveal in the daytime, living luxuriously. They are stains and blemishes on mankind, reviling in their deception, even as they feast with you. 14. They have eyes full of adultery, constantly looking for sin, enticing and luring away unstable souls, having hearts trained in greed. They are children of a curse, abandoning the straight road that is the right way to live. They have gone astray. They have followed the way of the false teacher Balaam, the son of Beor, who loves the reward of wickedness. 16. But he was rebuked for his own transgression. A mute donkey spoke with a man's voice and restrained the prophet's madness.
Listen, this one we are reading here. This man, the Bible says in the latter there, it says, at least he was
rebuked. Bible long.
You know, this one was rebuked. At least he was rebuked.
Oh,
and the donkey spoke.
Donkey abolela.
He was rebuked of his madness.
In other words,
greedy is madness. Greedy is madness. You could see here, number one was, you know, the ones you destroy, you said greedy will destroy you. Number two, you revel in your own daytime.
When I now
greedy deceive you, and you find yourself in living a luxurious life. It is deception. Look here, you have got everything by greedy. It reveals you in daytime, not in the night time. No, in other words, the word revere, it means you find yourself enjoying living in luxurious
life.
In daytime, not in the nighttime. So that's what the Bible says. That's
why
you find you admire people because of what they have, not in the daytime.
Uduma batho ka ntho tse bana ntjora mara e seng boshiwe montsiare.
They are living luxurious life.
Ba phela maphelo a boiphino.
They have mansions. They have houses.
Bana le dinto, bana le dilo ka moka, bana le ntho tsa bona.
The Bible says to them is deception.
Mara mo go bona ina ke bofura.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what I say. All these riches without God.
Botsa motho leng ga fore magoma ka ofela sina modimo ka
re. Is deception.
Ke ufureya.
Number 3.
Sabrar.
You cannot separate deception. You cannot separate greedy and adultery.
O ka se aroganye meha ba ro le botswa.
Automatically you are going to be in parties.
Ora ro to ba le mileto.
And then you also seduce unstable souls.
Ebe le o ta shishinya ba
That is your job. When you have got greed, you are greedy. You seduce, you make these people who are stable to be more misled. They will be admiring you, but they don't know the source of your progress. They can be misled. Not long I found, because that's what the Bible is talking about,
pastors.
I found one pastor was telling me that, I want to be a pastor there, but I must hire 3 cars. They look alike. And then show them on Facebook. It will be like, it's something to show how we are moving. And then from there, the cars are not mine, but I've been taking a picture when I come out. And then even when I'm walking, and then also when I'm entering a place where I'm guarded, I look at that
person,
I say, it's for what? He
said,
it's for my presentation. That one is done in business. The business people, they must do presentation.
You are a child.
This is to seduce unstable people. The moment you open there, you see 3 cars, you don't know whether it's not him or
for
him. You are going there to be blessed. And then now, because of greedy, he operates to take more from you. I don't know if you're hearing me. Many of us here in South Africa, we are affected by people who are greedy. And people who are greedy, they can just lie and say, you see, we are hiring people. I saw brothers in Boxburg. We say we are of the Liver Brothers. Pay how much?
We'll
give you a job. You register.
People are coming
to pay. In the last day, they went to the same office. They find solotape with newspapers. Closing all the windows. They were unstable. They followed. Many of you have been robbed by people who are greedy. I don't know if you're hearing me.
Because
you have been robbed by people who are greedy. They come to you, they lie to you. They end up robbing you. So the Bible says, where there is greedy, there is adultery. There is what?
Adultery.
Money is there.
The party.
There's a party 6 o'clock.
Una le party ka 6.
You don't know the time of ending.
A o tsebo re tata re fetsa nako mang.
You are going to dance there.
Le taba le bina na ke uwe.
Because people are greedy, they always use money to get you.
Batho ba ba nang le me aba re ba shumisa tshelete re ba o khwetse botse.
They pour wine.
Ba tshela beine.
They pour this one, the strong drink on your cold drink.
Ba tshela drink e ya strong gudugudu kana cold drink ya.
They know they will get you when you are using straw.
Ba o tsebo re ba ta go khwetsa o ntse o berekisa straw.
When you are doing like you begin to see two people.
A o sa nwa o ta bona batho ba le ba babedi motho ngo motho.
They go to you begin to see to be you begin to say which one.
O tomori o le yena kufi.
When you are doing like this they say come and dance you begin to say oh.
A o sa dia lo ba re ta wine.
Tomorrow you are HIV positive.
Ka o sa no HIV positive.
Unstable people are seduced.
Batho ba ba sa ye mang botsena ba furiwa ka batho.
In fact unstable people are tools of the greedy people.
Batho ba sa ye mang botse ke dithuloshi tja batho ba me aba.
Adultery is there, fornication is there.
Amen. Ka o bana na le me yo na le botswa. Amen.
The last thing there, if you can just read the last verse, mama.
Are ba le verse ya mafelela.
Yeah, it say what?
Abandoning the straight road that is the right way to live.
Yes.
They have gone astray. They have followed the way of the false teacher Balaam, the son of Beor, who loved the reward of wickedness, but he was rebuked for his own transgressions. A mute donkey spoke with a man's voice and restrained the prophet's madness.
Yeah, I thank God the Bible didn't say apostle, it said prophet.
Mogile wa mudimo ka re Bible ya re apostle ile ya re prophet.
He said, you know, they love to deceive to get money.
Ba rata o fura o gwetse tshelete.
Balaam was working that way.
Balaam na shuma ka tsela yeo.
One of the things that I was learning about Balaam was
Tweki tuteleng ka Balaam shi.
God said, don't go there.
Modimo icha uyena o ska ya.
He went there because of the price.
Ena ya ka le bakala moputso go na buditse gona.
Prophets, they love money.
Ba profeta ba rata miputso chelete.
The moment you hear prophet money.
Na go ye o ka go ba re prophet o tsebe chelete ka re.
You could hear this prophet going there.
Wa kwa mo profeta o ya yana ko we.
Thank God he was rebuked.
Le ba modimo ile a galemelwa tseleng.
I don't know if you hear it.
A ke tseba le ntwa.
Here you could see it's not pastor, it's not teacher, it's prophet.
A wa kona bona mo ra si muruti a si apostle teacher ke mo profeta.
And then he got a wrong prophet.
Ah, thola mopotso singona.
Even today is what is happening.
Le le gono ke ntwe di alang a staba ya hore.
All prophets love money.
Ke ba ka ofela ba ba ratang tshelete.
But today if you want to get money you must be prophet.
Le gona o nya go thola tshelete ka bogauswe ba mo profeta.
Yes, I'm a prophet.
Uno bolela wa rena ke mo profeta.
I'm a prophet. This thing is not starting now.
And ento a ithomi ana joache.
When I was growing up, we used to attend Zion Apostolic.
A ke gola ne re tsena kereke e ba re ke Zion Apostolic.
In Zion Apostolic there were many prophets.
Mo Zion Apostolic a simo profeta a simo profeta.
Others they were using ropes.
Ba ngo ba ba re ke sa di thapo.
They want to show that one that is bigger than.
O nyo ko bonchuru o la cha e ke di
nya. A rope like this.
O mo na le thapo o dula e dikurusha.
It's not even hot.
A officially ofishi mothomo wa tonya.
And the prophet will be realizing.
Utabadi ya thapo ya yana.
Yebo. I'm talking about my experience.
Ke bolela ka ntwe nna ke itsebang.
Next week.
Yebo ke tang.
You will see another one with a bigger robe than that.
Utabona mo a tshwere le thapo le lengwe le legologolo la ofita lela.
Even you say obise.
Le yana utabadi ya jwalo a idea tsana cheo.
I began to realize they were beginning to competing them by those ropes.
Ka thoma o bona re jona ngi competition ya dithapo.
Now there comes jacket now.
Jona o ta ma di jacket.
They put a cross behind here.
Jacket ya ona ita ba le sefapano ka mo mrao.
So when this one starts to dance showing them the cross.
Oh ah bi na mo no aya dukuluwa.
This is a task around avon chatapo.
Ke bolela taba tsa
khang. I see it when many more than 50 years ago.
Taba je ke di bone khale 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 ke Selomonyana.
When I was still many years.
Mengwa ye mingata ya ofita.
When it's turning like this showing say look at my cross.
A bon charge la ga yo lena le sefapano ka
mora. Look at my cross.
A le bona ansa ka sefapa.
When you turn like this.
Ah je ka mo better come around.
I will show him.
O lo more ke tamonja.
That other one by the following week.
Oh la ka beketang.
Big jacket that reached down.
Ubetha jase ngwe ya ofita kwa makutu.
And the cross is everywhere.
Sifapano sitete mukokoto ka ofela.
And from there is doing the same.
Kuto amoli ena uto ubetha ya hai.
You see, prophets, it has been a problem of prophets from the beginning.
Butata ba profeta ki butata ba uto
hale hale. Even by the time of Elijah.
Leka na kwa laya Elia.
He found the prophets of Baal.
Wela thola ba profeta ba Baal.
They compete.
Ne ba lwana ba ipapecha.
Micaiah.
Makaiya
also met the prophets.
Lena ukopana nibona ba ipapecha.
So even today.
Shona linazi.
When it's hard to market a job, it's hard to.
Awu nyaka mereka unyaka wa unyaka kuduka mata wa unyaka.
And you find that you can't get the job.
Watoloro mereka ute ubonale.
You go to the mountain.
Uya thabeng wa yodula li.
And spend 5 days there.
Wa fetcha machacha.
When you are hungry there.
Awu shereketala na mola 5 days.
Now you are so much hungry there.
U shereketala i u shere khut.
You descend as a prophet.
U thewa jana u setse wa pere bo profeta.
You want to make sure that you get money.
Bona uri thola.
There's too much deception.
Ona lo furea o gontsi.
When you reach there now, if you can't see anything, you go to Facebook.
Au fita mola o sabone modimo a sabole matho o sabone.
Ya
bokeng as fatem.
You start to send requests now.
O thoma o romela di request.
You get names there.
Tola mabicho.
It's your way of becoming greedy.
Gitsela ya hao ya ba le me ya baro.
From there you have names now.
O to wa mo tshwere mabicho.
You have got everything.
Na dilo ka ofela.
From there you begin to prophesy there.
O thoma ka mo thoma ba tsenela na mo Facebooku.
Facebook is your Holy Spirit.
Facebook yo nonke moyo halalela.
This is the time that we need to check how do we get that money.
Ke nna go ya re thole botsebotse re chelete e re ikgwetsa ka tselamang.
Let me give advice to the pastors.
Ere ke le fema ele ba ruti ba ishu.
If you prophesy 5 people.
How ka bolelishana le batho ka se profeta ba bathano.
And you are prophesying wrong.
And o sa boleli tsona.
You know what will happen?
Wa tsebo to diala.
Next week.
Beketang.
You will see 30 people.
O ta bona ba 30.
And you are supposed to prophesy.
And o tshwenje ro bolela le bona hape.
That other way you see 100.
Ye la be ke o ta bona ba le 100.
You can find yourself deceiving people.
O ka te hwetsa o tshwela pele, o tshwela pele o fura batho.
Because of greediness.
Ka le ba ka la me ha ba
re. Greediness will never allow you to be satisfied.
Me ha ba ro a di ro ro go tsofale.
I don't know if you are hearing that.
A ke tseba le ntwa.
Ecclesiastes 5:10-12.
Moeledi.
It says five. He who loves money,
you are
will never
chalete.
Be satisfied. Will never be satisfied.
Aga sgotsofane.
The sleep, Ecclesiastes 5:10-12.
Five,
the sleep
10 to 12.
Of a waking man is sweet.
Buroko ba mona ya berekang bo monate.
Whether it's little or much.
Ke ye bo bonyane go ba ke tse dinyane.
But the full stomach of a greedy man.
Mara se mpa ya mona wa megabaru ye teaching.
He hungers the more.
O swara ke tala lo feta.
And he will not allow him to sleep.
Mara e modumele mpa ye ora robale.
Look at somebody say please use your hands.
Ako bo tshemtolong ang kumberekise matso.
You must work.
Ako bereke ngwana papa.
You must do something by yourself.
Ngo di esesingwe ka bo wena.
There's nobody, listen, there's nobody who's too late to go to school.
Awana motho nako isetse mufitile ora ye ko sekolo.
You can learn a trade.
O ka ithuta ntwe icheng.
You work for yourself.
Wa te berekela wa shuma.
You do everything by yourself.
Wa ya dilo cheka mfela
ka bo wena. Inviting God, he will help you.
Mama di mo ta uthusha.
I don't know if you're hearing that.
Ake tseba le ntwa.
Look at that verse, read in Amplified by it says what?
Ane le verse yela.
10.
Verse 10.
Yes.
He who loves money will not be satisfied with money, nor he who loves abundance will with its gain. This too is vanity called emptiness. When good things increase, those who consume them increase. So what advantage is there to their owners except to see them with their eyes? The sleep of a working man is sweet, whether he earns little or much, but the full stomach greed of a rich who hungers for even more will not let him sleep.
I want to tell you that many people are not sleeping. Tonight you must sleep in Jesus'
name.
You are thinking, how can I make money? How can
I?
You are looking where you are staying. You are questioning why other people. Can you be satisfied with what you have and invite God
and
sleep of a righteous man,
the
one who works for by his hands, is so sweet. But this one can't sleep. I know many people can't sleep. If the others sleep with a calculator, other the phone must be on. They are greedy. When they wake up, there's no message that there's a wife. I'm expecting how much. They are always expecting. Others, they are doing business. They want this business to run very fast. Everything starts small.
Because
though your beginning is small, your latter end will flourish. Don't rush to be on top. Every step takes you away. A greedy man tries to make money in a wrong way. You know, when God stops you for a while and you guide, maybe you've got two members, you're a pastor, God is teaching you to be faithful to him. Three, four, five. Nicely, you are going with God. Even when there are thousands, they won't control you. I don't know if you're hearing me. Why now when you are blessed, you forget God? Can't sleep. Money that you put it to yourself can be dangerous to yourself. It calls others to
makes
you develop some ways of greediness. Small thing you eat, you sleep. I understand we are not training the right way.
In the same way.
I was trained by God that I must leave my job. And when I leave my job, I come to trust God with nothing. But now I can't say, you see, I want this, I want that. I was trained to trust God with nothing. I don't know if you're hearing me. But now, if you are focusing in money, right now, yeah, I was supposed to be saying, I want money. I prophesy to get money. Let me prophesy you to get money. That is the reason why people today, they prophesy and speak things which are useless. That's the reason why Satan is attacking the ministries today. Because of greediness. Another one just said, okay, this one can prophesy. I start my church. Another one said, I want to do this. This greed is sending us to hell. No one can die of hunger. Can you tell about? No one can die of hunger. Satisfaction in the things of God can fill your stomach. So this is the problem we have today. Today, this greedy will leave you in Jesus' name. I
say,
this greedy will leave you in Jesus' name. Colossians 3, verse 5. Greediness replace your devotion with God. In other words, greedy is idolatry.
Just read.
Verse
5.
Yes.
So put to death and deprive of power the evil longings of your earthly body with its sensual, self-centered instinct, immorality, impurity, sinful passion, evil desire, and greed, which is a kind of idolatry because it replaces your devotion to God.
Can you hear the greediness replaces your devotion with God? The moment you are greedy, you can't worship God. You worship money. Jesus said you cannot serve two masters. You can't serve God and
mammon.
Because already you are not finding, you know, the ways from God to get that money. You get it from your thoughts. And you end up worshipping Satan.
Ephesians 5:3. By Ephesians 5:3.
That verse challenged me this week.
Verse challenged me good.
You say what?
But sexual immorality and all moral impurity,
yes,
indecent offensive behavior, or greed must not even be hinted at among you, as is proper among saints. For as believers, our way of life, whether in public or in private, reflect the validity of our faith.
Our reflection of our faith shows that greedy must not be mentioned among us.
Essays.
This is validity of our faith. The moment you found a greedy person, run away. Because the Bible says it must not be mentioned. Sexual sin. Greedy is one thing. I don't know if you're hearing that. Sexual sin and greedy must not be mentioned in our Christian faith among our lives. In fact, listen to this. If we go back to the book of Acts
2,
if we look at those Christians who were one soul, one spirit, sharing together, you will find that greedy was not there. Sin was not there. Calling each other my brother, my sister, my brother. Now today, because of greedy, there is charis. There is faith mission. There is what? It's greedy. Greedy makes us to be separated. That church is not of God. That one is not a man of God. I'm a big man of God. This one is small. This is competition because of greedy. Sexual sin. Greedy. Are not supposed to be mentioned as we are saints. That is the validity, like a certificate of being a Christian. If you are a Christian, for example, I can give an example. The Bible talks about, you see, when to be a bishop. To be a bishop, you must have one wife. And have children who will fear God. And the Bible says, if a bishop,
you
are supposed to be able to control your house. You cannot control the work. You cannot hold anything in the house of God if you are failing in your
house.
This is the validity of a bishop. I don't know if you're hearing me. So therefore, if we don't find that, please, you are not a
bishop.
If we don't find that, if you have got, if you have got two wives, children answer, you're not a bishop. The bishop must have a one wife,
bishop,
and the children that fear him. Not children that are outside and somewhere. Not a bishop. I don't know if you hear me. So same applies to this. A validity of a Christian for you to say you are a saint, sexual sin and greedy must not be mentioned in your life. If we found that you're not a Christian, if we found that, even if you say I'm a Christian, we'll tell you you are not. I don't know if you're hearing that. This is the time that we check our lives. Ask someone, say, hey, do you think you don't have greedy? Are you not greedy?